Good afternoon, children of class 12th, biology group. Children, today we'll be looking at the ninth part as we continue with the eighth chapter, evidences and theories of biological evolution. And in the past eight videos, we were looking at the evidences of evolution, but today we will be concentrating on the theories of evolution. Some of these portions you studied in class 10th also, and we had studied that organic evolution is the process by which simple organisms give rise to complex organisms in course of time. So complex organisms, they come from simpler organisms. Since science of genetics was established, many theories were put forward. Even from before 1900 AD to explain the organic evolution. We had already studied about Jean-Baptiste Lamarck. Jean-Baptiste Lamarck was a French naturalist, and he was there from 1744 to 1829. He was first a botanist and then he became a zoologist. He gave his views on inheritance of acquired characters. That what he said was that characters, they are acquired due to the change in environment or the use or disuse of organs of the body. These characters are acquired and then they are inherited by the offsprings. And this he said in 1809 in his book. And what was his book called? His book was called Philosophique Zoologique. And he gave the theory of Lamarckism. This you already started in 10th. This is the theory given by Lamarck, and he gave the following rules or postulates, as we say. Let us look at these four rules one by one. One of the rules was in his theory that growth, living organisms and their component parts tend to increase in size continuously. Then the second rule of his Lamarckism theory was that new organs, as a result of need, came about. That means formation of new parts or organs of the body took place according to new need of what arose in the life of an organism. Then we see the use and disuse. A development of organs takes place and its continuous use strengthens that organ which is being used more. But other organs which are not being used, they slowly degenerate or disintegrate. Inheritance of acquired characters. We see that Lamarck also gave the fourth rule of inheritance of acquired characters. All the changes which organisms acquire during their lifetime, they transmit to their offsprings through inheritance. Now, let us look at two important aspects. According to Lamarck's theory, organisms change and evolve through the times. Firstly, we see that the changes occur when the environment alters the phenotype of the organism. With ma'am, you have already studied what the phenotype is, or the outside look of an organism is. So this is altered by the changing environment. And the second thing which Lamarck theory said was that this information of phenotypic change is passed on from somatic cells. That means cells which are found in other parts of the body, like the liver, like the spleen, like stomach. All these are called somatic cells. So phenotypic change is passed from the somatic cells to the reproductive cells or the sex cells of the body. And from the sex cells, in the form of gametes, these changes are transmitted from the parents to the offspring. The evidences in form of Lamarckism, we can give some examples. Like, see the giraffe's neck. Do you see here in this picture? The giraffe's neck. Lamarck believed that giraffe's neck grew longer through the generations as the giraffe stretched out his neck to reach the leaves of tall trees. And the farther away the leaves of the tall plants were there from the giraffe, he stretched his neck further. And so his neck, the giraffe's neck, became longer. And he stretched its neck to reach the leaves of the tallest trees. The trait of stretching of giraffe's neck was transmitted in gametes and became a permanent trait. Then let us also see at the feet of the modern horse. The ancestors of modern horse, they lived on soft jungle ground. This we studied in the evidences of paleontology in the second or the third video, if you remember. So the Ouyuhippus horse, this used to live in jungle areas that were marshy, the jungle ground that was soft. And later the soft ground was replaced by dry grasslands, and the horses began to graze on hard grounds. And so the change in habit made a reduction of the number of digits and the lengthening of the legs. This we already know when we studied paleontology. And from a sluggish running swamp living animal which treaded on soft ground, the legs changed to a swift running hooved animal of the modern horse. Then we see the loss of limbs in snakes. You must be remembering that how we studied about the loss of the limbs in snake. And if you remember that the ancestors of the snakes, they had short limbs. The continuous creeping through holes and narrow crevices made the limbs useless for locomotions, and these limbs were completely lost. Then the same unique example we see in three other animals. Let us talk about these one by one. We see the same kind of changes in other animals. Deep sea fish, called the flat fish, has both eyes on one side of the body because of the pressure of tons of water of sea. This deep fish has got now both eyes on one side of the body. Likewise, let's see another unique example. Reduced eyes in moles. Moles are found digging in tunnels underneath the earth's surface. So reduce eyes in moles as they dig most of the time in underground tunnels. Then we see webbed feet developed in swimming birds, like we have ducks. So it is thought that the webbed feet developed slowly in the birds because they utilize their feet more and more for swimming, and so their phenotypic characteristics were transmitted through their gametes or the genes into their offsprings from the parents. We also see criticism of Lamarckism. There were certain people who criticized the theory of Lamarck. And one of the most famous ones is August Weismann. In 1890, he gave the greatest blow to Lamarck's theory. Let us see some of the experiments which August Weismann did. In one of his experiments, he kept on cutting the tails of rats for nearly 20 generations, but could not get tailless rats. And likewise, we see, he also noticed that a blacksmith develops very powerful biceps by continuous use of his arms. But his offsprings did not inherit his biceps. Likewise, we see that by shaving throughout our lives, we cannot produce beardless sons. We shave for 40, 50 years in our lives, but still we do not produce a son who doesn't shave or who is beardless. Likewise, let us take an example of women of China who wear iron shoes, small iron shoes, to reduce their feet to shorter size, because short-sized foot is considered a beauty in China. But we see their young ones have normal feet at birth when they are born. So through all these examples, August proved that Lamarckism theory was not true. Now, there were also supporters of Lamarckism. These were known as Neo-Lamarckism. Before we go there, let us see an important aspect, that all the examples of criticism of Lamarckism, they clearly reveal that the acquired characters affect only the body and are entirely somatic. That means the acquired characters are only in the somatic cells, not in the sex cells. And they do not affect the germ cells. Hence, they cannot be transmitted to the next generation. The effect of environment and of use and disuse produce variations, but such variations are never inherited. This was very strongly given by the critics of Lamarckism. Now let us once again come to Neo-Lamarckism. Recently it has been shown that environment can influence genes, and these may bring such distinct changes that the organisms that acquired them are graded as totally different species. Let us, for example, look at these people. And what were these people categorized as? The category of evolutionists which support the Lamarckism doctrine of inheritance of acquired characters are called Neo-Lamarckians. There was a scientist by the name of Tauber. He showed that under abnormal conditions of moisture and temperature, potato beetles, such beetles or insects which were found in potatoes, produced offsprings which differed clearly from their parents. These changes were inherited in the next generation. So Tauber was a Neo-Lamarckian, so he showed this true example. Then let us look at another example. It was also reported that when rough non-type specific forms of type 2 pneumococci causing pneumonia were exposed to the extracts of dead smooth type 3 pneumococci, then the second type changed into smooth type 3 pneumococci. So this also shows that the phenotypic change, because of the environment also became a change in the genes or genotypic change. Both Lamarckism and neo-Lamarckism assume the inheritance of acquired characters. According to Lamarckism, these acquired characters result from needs, whereas neo-Lamarckism shows the rules that these characters are induced due to environment and habit of individuals. So with this, we would like to conclude this video 9 here itself, and next time we would look at the theory of natural selection, Darwinism, and we will see other principles of evolutionary theories also. So till then, wish you all the best and do well. Thank you.